Mr. Vice President, this is financial assistance, a loan without any form of collateral. How sustainable can this program be? Supposing the people who give the money just absconded, remember it's cash.
Let me explain two things. The first is that in many parts of the world, there is what is even called social security. In other words, even if you are not working, some allowance is made in terms of payments so as to sustain you, especially when you are extremely poor. Now, that by itself is supposed to even empower people and is supposed to enable people to continue to survive, even where they're not making a living. But this is even different. This is a case where you have traders, people who have shown a willingness and an ability to trade and to make money and to work hard. So working with them, you know, ensuring that we're able to give them more credit so that they can improve their inventory is a very important thing for them and also for us. If you find a person who has been working hard even before you give them any money, and there's also the promise that when you pay back, you'll be given another a larger amount. Generally speaking, you'll find that repayment is never a problem. As a matter of fact, what we have found with microcredit is that the percentage of repayment is usually extremely high, compared to some of what we've seen, compared to some of what we see with even bigger, with bigger debtors, if you like. Obviously, for the smaller people, I think there's a great deal of integrity. And we trust that payments will be made, because in any event, it's good for their business.